Hey everyone, welcome back to How To. I'm Shubham and in this video we are going to learn how to create sign up using Django and Django REST framework. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe to our channel, like this video and also comment if you have any questions or any suggestions. So let's get started now. First of all, we are going to create our virtual environment. And now activate the environment. Now that we have our environment activated, let's install the Django and Django REST framework. So I'm going to come over here, install Django REST framework and also the Markdown. Now that we have created our environment and installed everything, let's create our project. Now we should navigate inside the project, that is SRC, and then we will have to create our Django app. So it will be same thing, Django admin start app. And I'll call it as first. Now that the app and project is created, let's minimize this and check the structure. So here we have one more source and inside this we have settings.py and then we have our first app. Okay, so since we have created our first app, we must also install it inside our settings.py under installed apps. So I'm going to do that. And now since we have also installed REST framework, so we need to install it inside the installed apps. I've done that. Now everything is done. Let's go inside our views.py. Since we don't have much of things to be done, I'm not going to create a separate file called as serializers.py. I'm just going to write the serializer inside our views.py itself. So first of all, we need to import few things from a REST framework. So I'm going to do that from REST framework import. First of all, I need view sets, serializers, and we are going to make use of Django's user model. So it will come from Django contrib.auth.models import user. If you all are not already familiar with Django's user model, let me show you. So on this Django's official website, if you check this, Django already has a user model which has fields like username, first name, last name, email, password, group, and all these fields are present inside the Django user model. We can directly use the same model to create our signup API, or we can use this model to create our own user model and use that. But in this video, we are going to just use the Django's user model to create the signup API. So for this, first of all, we are going to write our serializer class. So class user serializer. Serializers.model serializer, and then over here we are going to override the default fields, that is password we are going to override, and we are going to use serializers.care field over here, which we'll use only for write only. So this means that whenever we are calling the API and if user serializer is being used, it will not show this password field to the user, and only when we are submitting data, that is doing post or put, that time this field will be accessible. After that, we'll also set a minimum length for the password. So I'm going to define this minimum length over here on top. I'll keep it as 8. And then I'm going to write also error message, so that if any error is made, this message will be shown. And if the error is related to minimum length, then we are going to show this. And we are going to make use of this same min length over here. I'm making use of f strings over here so that I can directly insert the min length over here. Now that is done. Also, when we do a sign up, there is always not just one time password entry, but we have to enter it twice. So I'm going to do that. Basically, what we can do is we can just copy paste it. So this will be password 2, and same error, same thing. Now after that, we also need to, since this is a model serializer, so it needs a model. So I'm going to write class meta, which will be which will have model, which is the user model that we just imported from Django contrib auth models, and also we are going to specify the fields. Fields will be, I'm going to directly put in all the fields, so it will be underscore underscore all underscore underscore 2 times. So that is that. So whenever we do a sign up, we always make sure that password 1 and password 2, that is a repeating password, both are matching, and then only we proceed with setting up the password, right? So for that, we are going to use serializers validate method, and we are going to override it right now. So def validate, I'm going to call this attributes as data, because I like that way, and we are going to do matching of that. So if the data, inside data we have a field called as password, is not matching to the this second password, so that will be also inside data, then we should raise an error. Since we are inside serializer, so we do raise an error and not return error. Okay, serializers dot validation error, and we are going to call it as password does not match. So here we go, our validation is done, and if not that, then we directly return the data. I don't want to do all those things. Yes, so this is done. And when we create, we just save one password, right, and not both the passwords. So for that, we are going to override the serializer's create method. So def create self, and we have now validated data given to this method. I'm going to receive it like that, and now we are going to create our user object. So user, this is the model user objects dot create, and we are going to pass in whatever we want. So like, I want username is present, so I want that username to be validated username, and then we also pass in email, right? So we want to do that validated data. From validated data, we want the email field. Okay, we also have first name, so from validated data we need the first name, and I'm going to save the last name as well. Validated data, last name, and also there is one field called as active, which also will be validated data and active. Likewise, you can write all the fields that are present from here, like email, password, everything. So this is done. Now we are going to set the user's password. So it will be user.set_password, and this will also come as validated data, and from there we are going to take the password field. And since we have assigned the password to the user, now we will have to do user.save. And then finally we do return from here, that is return user. So that's it for the serializer. Now that our serializer has been done, let's go ahead and create our view set. So we are going to call it as class user view set, and this will be taking view sets dot model view set. And since it's a model view set, we need to specify the query set that will be from the user model. So user.objects.all, and also we need to tell the model view set that we are passing a serializer class, that is this user serializer that we just created over there. So now let's go ahead and create a router for this. We are going to go inside the source URL. Since there is just one view set that we have created, so I'm not going to create a separate urls.py for this first app. You can go ahead and create that, but I'm just going to do it inside the urls.py of source directory. So I'm going to import that view. Okay, so from first app import a view. So this has imported our views file, and we now also need from the REST framework router. So from REST framework dot routers import, I want default router, and then we are going to create an object of that. Router is equal to default router, and then use that router dot register on default path, that is on blank, we will call the views. We'll call this views dot user view set we just created. Okay, and then we are going to use this URL patterns to append that. URL patterns plus equal to router dot URLs. Also, we haven't specified the Django REST frameworks URLs over here, so we are going to do that. I'm going to copy it from this website itself and paste it over here. Since include is not imported, we need to import the include over here. That will come from django.conf.urls import include. Now that everything is done, we just have to migrate and test it out. So let's do that now. For that we have to do python manage.py make migrations, just to verify if there is any migrations left. Oh, we have some error. Okay, so in the views.py under user serializer, this should be error message and not default error message. Same over here, error message and not default error message. And python manage.py make migrations, no changes detected, that is fine. And then we are going to do python manage.py migrate. So now everything is done. Let's run the code. Python manage.py run server. So here we go. We have now our endpoint ready to create a new user. So let's test it out. I'm going to enter some password, and we can keep last login as blank and super user. If you want to create a super user, you can give that. Otherwise, you can keep that also blank. And then we are going to give the username as admin. I'll keep everything is admin itself, admin, and also email address, say admin@admin.com. Then I want to give it active user. So that's it, that much only. And then we are going to post. Sorry, there is one more error and we are going to rectify it. In creating the user, inside validate data username, it should be username and not validated data. So that was a small problem. So I think we can fix it. I'm going to just press F5 and continue. Yes. And also one more problem we are facing, that is active. Okay, let's remove this. I don't think we need this, because by default the active status is true for the user. So again, and there we go, a new user is created. Okay guys, so that's it for this video, and I hope you have learned something new in this video. If you have, do like the video, subscribe to our channel, and also comment. Thank you, see you next time.